Hear ye, hear ye. Put down your crack pipes and get up here. Well, what can we say about the past couple days besides the people have spoken? The cardboard turtle insurrection has begun. Yesterday, as far as I'm concerned, the cops were pretty well behaved compared to what would have happened in San Francisco, let alone LA. But now that I hear people are being pepper sprayed inside of buses, law and order broke down among the police department today. Yeah, they did overreact today. I mean, way less protesters, way more arrests. On Channel 7 clearly had footage of them pepper spraying people who were shopping or trying to get home from work for the office. Some of it maybe was because they had so many other cops from other departments. It was that old who's on first, who's on second. Oh, I don't know. I think I'll just fuck some people up. Spray, 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 spray. It only takes one rogue attacking Starbucks to taint a whole protest. And it only takes one rogue cop to fuck shit up even worse. And there were quite a few today, from what I understand. Again, nowhere near as horrific as what would happen in California or New York, let alone China. And we should be thankful for that. And the fact that everybody who had the balls to come down to this show was able to come down without getting taken away and pepper sprayed in a fucking bus. So the people have spoken, and this is a kind of a shot across the bow, or even the first shot, hole in the side, direct hit in the good ship, or should we say, bad Exxon Valdez or toxic waste barge called the WTO. This is step one. And we have won one major, maybe two major victories. Number one, the biggest weapon the WTO creatures had is that nobody knew who they were. Well, some of us did, but hardly anybody knew who they were, what they were up to, or all the way they've been fucking up people's lives on the planet all over the world, just so people who already have so much money they don't know what the fuck to do with it can make more money and more money and more money. It's almost like an addiction, right? Wealth addiction? Who is more dangerous to public order, a crack addict or a wealth addict? Our government's own statistics from the Federal Reserve Board, we're talking Alan Greenspan here, admit that 80% of the American people have seen dick all from this supposed economic boom. It's the other 20% who are gentrifying the buildings, forcing poor people and artists and people of color out on the street, tootling along in their sport utility vehicles, running red lights while they're talking on their cell phones because the laws don't apply to them. That's 20%. The other 80% are in the same boat we are and don't even know it. Or do they? The other great victory that's given me so much energy and yes, even optimism from what's gone down in this town is you got people who one side was dismissed as tree huggers marching along side by side people that they would dismiss as rednecks or hard hats. Finally, we are communicating with each other, I hope. The WTO and the upward flow of money to people who don't need it, that's not some bullshit left-wing, right-wing issue. That is the top versus the bottom. The top is even less than 20% of the population, ain't it? So, here we have all this energy, all these different kinds of people who we might not agree with on everything, all focused on the same thing. That is why Seattle, the battle in Seattle, is a shot heard around the world. We are making history. Isn't it better than staying home and watching it on TV? Isn't it better to follow Nike's suggestion and just do it than to be a spectator in your own life? So, now what do we do? The most important thing we can take from all this, how many of you came here from outside of Seattle? Okay, this applies to inside Seattle too. After a couple days and a few more TV people saying, "The protesters ruined Christmas. There's no shopping downtown." Once that's not the flavor of the hour anymore, WTUTO may disappear off the radar screen, and they'll be telling us it's much more important to worry about how many millions of dollars Toy Story 2 took in this week, or what's Brad Pitt up to now, or you know, the other things that they push at us, celebrities, icons, and no issues in the regular press. Can George, King George II beat Al Gore, Bill Bradley? But nothing about the issues. They don't want to say that because all those people agree with each other too much anyway. Especially when it comes to phony free trade. Anyway, that's what we're being presented with. So our job now to keep this pot, keep the stove boiling. Don't hate the media, become the media. Take what you felt here, what you've learned here, what you know about the WTO. This ain't the X-Files, this is not black helicopters, this is real and this is worse. Take this out to the people you know, who you don't necessarily normally agree with or shoot the shit with. Family, people at work, people at school. You hear people spouting Rush Limbaugh bullshit or Pat Buchanan bullshit or Bill Clinton, Al Gore, Bill Bradley bullshit. Communicate with them. Don't dismiss them as stupid or rednecks or hopelessly unreachable. If they're frustrated because they can't put food on the table, that's our big fucking wedge issue and everybody's fucking reachable. Tell them what the WTO is, how it's designed to let tin horn dictators from one country in the pay of American or Europe-based multinationals go clear across our borders or someone else's borders and nuke their democratically enacted sovereign laws. This isn't democracy. This isn't even capitalism. This is feudalism. New feudalism. Remember that phrase, new feudalism. Because this isn't barons and lords in high castles with little peasants, terrified peasants on the other side of the moat tilling the land anymore. New feudalism means we know who the people in the high castles are, and every time we buy anything from Exxon or Microsoft or Time Warner or Blockbuster Video or Walmart or Home Depot or Toys R Us or Buns and Nubile Books or whatever, we are their serfs. And nobody can divorce themselves from corporate feudalism all the way unless you want to be as pure and politically correct as the Unabomber. Maybe not everybody wants that. So this means when we become the media and take this knowledge of the WTO and turn around and fuck shit up in a good way and go after their agenda and fuck with it, we can't come from a fundamentalist fundamentalist radical point of view. You gotta pick a moral code and a lifestyle you can not only live with, but live up to, and then you won't become as miserable as Ted Kaczynski or see things in such black and white issues that if this cramps your style, you figure, I don't like this anymore. I guess I'll just become a computer yuppie instead. If you don't go so far over this way, you're less likely to spring like a rubber band and turn into this on the other side. And so the multinationals, the chains, the arms of the new feudalist WTO, don't give them your money. To the degree that you can, boycott all chains. support local businesses, local bookstores, local music stores, local organic markets, local organic farmers, things like that. No one can do it 100%, but the more you do and the more you encourage other people to do, the less money they can make off of you. For crying out loud, don't work for them. But knowing how hard it is to pay skyrocketing rents and find meaningful work you can actually live on, well, if you must work for them, at least remember that the computer age has ushered in a whole new frontier of sabotage on the job. A prank a day keeps the dog leash away. Think about it. And if you do wind up in a lucrative career, computer whiz, lawyer, doctor, dentist, contractor, whatever, there's still a way to give back to the community by giving back to the community and providing your services for people who can't afford it for free every once in a while. That's a way to give something back. And don't forget where you came from. Don't be the people like the people in the 60s and the 70s who decided that once the Vietnam War was over, they didn't have to work to change things anymore. Those people became the yuppie monsters and the Clintonoids who fuck our lives up today on a daily basis. Remember this. Remember who you are and why you feel who you are. And if and when you have kids, pass that on to your kids. And here's how to do it. Every time something unpleasant comes on the news and your kid's watching it, don't change the channel. Talk to them about it. Talk intelligently about it. Explain it to them. Share the knowledge with them. I mean, my parents were very open. I knew what race riots were. I knew what the Vietnam War was. I knew what all kinds of shit was when I was real small. I dug it. I've always been a news hound. But people I know now, I'm 41 now, a lot of people I know or people my age have no tangible personal memory of Vietnam or even Watergate. And I think that's because their Eisenhower brainwashed parents decided to put the blinders on whenever the Biafra War or the Vietnam War or anything that they didn't want them to see came on TV, they changed the channel. Don't make your kids stupid. The more the schools and the TV does it, the more you gotta counter that, and that's how to be good parents. So on that note, we got a lot of work to do. Right now, let's face it, it's Advantage WTO. They have the money, they have the power, they have the guns, they have the organization. This is the same situation we in this country faced with the Vietnam War, and guess what? We stopped the Vietnam War. It can be done, and it must be done. And if we sustain our energy and our vision and spread the positive disease, one thing this visit to Seattle has given me, I think it may take as long as Vietnam, as much work as Vietnam, as much not giving up as Vietnam, but in the end, the wealth addicts have gotten carried away. We're gonna win.